Brain Rehab Clinic is proud to announce that they're the first clinic in Utah to have on-site the GyroStem. And welcome back to Talk 365 TV. Holly Love, Trip Mitchell, it's a beautiful morning. We're getting lots done. Hey, let's talk a little bit about Dr. Hatch. He's doing a webinar, which is a really cool way to learn a lot more information about things that are challenges. And where he comes at brain injuries is a little bit different than a lot of people.
Absolutely.
And so he's got some real insight. And the advantage to the webinar is the fact that you will have gained so much information that if you go in and visit with the doctor, you'll be on top of everything. And he can just, he doesn't have to explain the whole program, can find out as much from you as possible.
Exactly.
And customize it.
Yeah. So we had a chance to chat with Dr. Hatch about how functional neurology and dealing with the way the brain is working alleviates the symptoms of anxiety and depression. He's become an expert by default, he says, in those conditions. So obviously, understanding what is happening in your brain and the diagnostic testing that he is able to do with your eyes and your balance to really just fine-tune and know exactly what's going on for you, it's just incredible when we're talking suicide prevention and we're talking mental health issues and what a problem it is. People who are suffering, they feel like they're at the end of their rope. In fact, the day we shot, he had a man who had come from Southern Utah for a week and did a week intensive, and they basically pulled him out of, he was in like a hospital, and he said he'd never felt better at the end of that week.
I have no sympathy for people who don't understand mental illness in terms of how it can affect people, because you look on the surface. And in a couple, very prominent suicide last year, Anthony Bourdain. And we watch him all the time. Brilliant TV host. If you can't understand that, you need to maybe rethink your life, because you do not have any empathy.
Yeah.
So Holly had a chance to talk to Dr. Hatch about that very subject and how brain injuries can really affect you. Take a look. Talk 365 TV's Talking Wellness is brought to you by Brain Rehab Clinic with wellness team expert Dr. John Hatch.
Hey everybody, welcome to another Talking Wellness. Today I am back with our wellness team expert, Dr. John Hatch, here at the Brain Rehab Clinic, one of my favorite places to come. How are you?
Thank you, so good. So good to be here.
Good. So I'm really excited about today because I always love talking functional neurology with you. And one thing that you have become an expert by default is treating anxiety and depression. So today we're going to talk about the science behind how you treat anxiety and depression here at the clinic. But before we get into that too much, I want to chat about being the expert in your field and why you say it's by default.
Well, when I first started working as a chiropractic neurologist, I treated a lot of concussions, head traumas, and most of their number one finding that was associated with head trauma was irritability, uneasiness. The parents noticed a change in behavior after the child suffered a head trauma. Okay. Prior to the head trauma, there was no behavioral problems. Kid was excellent in school, kid was happy, social, and then all of a sudden everything shifted. Mm-hmm. And they never understood why. And they had been to therapists, they had done their work. And so by default, I realized that a lot of those dealing with emotional imbalances and irritability mm-hmm. is coming from a neurological background. And mm-hmm. so that's why I work heavily with a lot of therapists, psychologists, psychiatrists, all of those counselors, family, marriage relationships. People don't realize that a lot of their affective head traumas and other types of neurological imbalances mm-hmm. cause more of a reaction than even the emotional side.
So it's not necessarily a chemical imbalance in the brain. It's a functional imbalance with the brain.
And it's just a huge part of it. What I always want to do is, how well is your foundation? Mm-hmm. If we're taking a medication to change something, if we're speaking about going through our past experience, PTSD, whatever it may
sure.
be, the question is, how good is your foundation? And I'm talking about the foundation of the brain. The true brain, its brainstem, how it all integrates specifically with emotional, it's a game changer.
Wow. So let's talk about why the body reacts the way it does to the brain imbalance. Mm-hmm. Like, why is it that you have symptoms of depression or symptoms of anxiety, and how are they different?
So the biggest thing that I realized in my research and understanding how brain function is the difference between the anxiety and depression comes highly with its involvement in the brainstem. Your brain's first law of nature is survive. Mm. So a brain, if a bear comes through that door, you're gonna go into a stress response faster than anything. It's the difference of why one kid's allergic to a bee and another kid's not allergic to a bee. A bee flies in or is on its cup and one's trying to flick it and the other one is panically running out the door. Mm-hmm. That reflex comes from a neural integration in your brain via sound, via vision, and it instantly relates and correlates with your heart rate, so it boosts the heart rate. All of that autonomic we talk about system.
You cannot control that.
You can't control it. It's reflexive. And so the question is your system already at a higher threshold than normal, mm-hmm. which is creating more anxiousness than you
normal.
Should be dealing with?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. For people who are looking for an alternative to what is out there for you, which is just, you know, medication that makes you sleepy or whatever it may be, what you do here is so different. So talk about how you found the treatment and why it's working so well, because people
Absolutely.
Quickly see results.
Absolutely. And again, I don't treat the anxiety. I don't treat mm-hmm. the depression. I don't look at their medications. I don't alter anything. I don't touch that world. My profession is to look at what is working and what is not working specifically in the brain.
Which is a whole other thing if you're on medication or you've been on medication for a long time and it's not working. Mm-hmm. Coming here, it's not like you're gonna tell them throw it in the garbage or you won't treat them. It's you will have enhancement because when your brain is functioning, everything else works. So if you've mentioned this before, if you've been suffering with something longer than a few months and you're not seeing a result from whatever program you're doing, whether it be weight loss, whether it be a medication for depression or anxiety or whatever, and it's not working the way it should, get in here, because you will be able to see immediately through your testings if there's something wrong with the brain or it's not.
Yeah, and most of the anxious patients that do come into the clinic, their findings aren't the same. Mm-hmm. And so no two experiences are the same, and that's what frustrates people, because we like a cookie cutter program. We like, this works for all. I'm never claiming that. I know mm-hmm. that I just have to find what's not working and get it to work correctly.
Yeah.
And it's simple by activating the brain and how the brain connects appropriately. We had a patient in just last week, severe anxiety, mm-hmm. and this individual patient, in the dark, went massively cross-eyed. So that brain, when your eyes come together, it activates the midbrain, which is your fight or flight part of the brain. Mm-hmm. So this poor girl is in a constant state of stress, and it has nothing to do with the psychological outside world. Mm-hmm. Though therapy and everything has worked to help, it hasn't jumped her to the next level, because they're missing a key component that they didn't even see. Because when you look at them, they look completely normal.
So for me, with the anxiety that I was experiencing at such a heightened level, was due to the brain injury. And so learning that it can be because of an injury that you just recently had, or one that you had when you were a kid and it went untreated. Mm-hmm. So let's talk about that.
Yeah, a lot of times these get untreated. You can see an ocular breakdown in a head trauma up to 40 years, because mm-hmm. the brain can't heal itself. The brain repairs, otherwise we never get old. We never get crepitous and change.
Uh-huh.
With a brain repairs itself with what it has, and sometimes those head traumas, even 40 years later, are still going on. And I think
wow.
the biggest thing is people don't always know if they do have anxiety. Is it due to an emotional thing? Is it due to a neurological thing? My always big question is, when that car jumps out in front of you, or that dog, and your heart rate boosts and that fight or flight goes, how quickly can you calm right back down and be you? If you sustain that for X amount of minutes, sometimes hours,
mm-hmm.
it's the person in the middle of the night that gets startled and then their heart rate's going and they're sitting there for an hour,
mm-hmm.
that's a neurological thing, not necessarily an emotional thing, because it was a true neurological reflex coming out of a sleep to be startled.
Well, and I think because there is so much wonderful stuff out there for self-help, can be really hard on people who are suffering with anxiety and depression, because you know, you should just be able to wake up and choose to be happy,
mm-hmm.
right? That
mm-hmm.
famous thing. And it's, if you have a brain problem, you can't override it. If you are in the best therapy in the world, you cannot override what is happening with the dysfunction mm-hmm. in the
yep.
brain.
And the perfect example is, as we spoke earlier, with that lady that had her eyes pinned together in a convergent spasm that wasn't seen. We can't will ourselves to uncross those eyes when mm-hmm. we didn't ever know they were crossed.
Yeah. Yeah, and just like with the tactile response too, mm-hmm. if you've hit the back of your head ever, how your balance will be off. And if your balance and your center of gravity is off, your body is in a constant state of nervous
stress. Mm-hmm.
Which then ups the ante when mm-hmm. you are in a situation of stress, then you're just twice as stressed yep. as what would be considered mm-hmm. normal,
yep.
right?
And then those dealing with like more depression, mm-hmm. we know it's frontal lobe, we know it's dopamine driven. So the more your eyes move in a given day, especially post head trauma, a lot of the eyes aren't stable. They'll complain of blurry vision. They'll say, I have brain fog. And these little movements in the eyes is using up that frontal energy and frontal integrity. And Ooh. Then they start to see decline in depression and drive because their brain is neurologically tired on top of whatever else is going on.
Chemically or otherwise. Mm-hmm.
There's always other components. My
sure.
question is how is that foundation? When that foundation is solid, the other things work. I've had multiple patients on medications for years that never worked. We got their brain aligned and that medication did exactly what it was supposed to do. And the person is living life, so to speak, depression free because she's using the correct medication with a brain that actually works.
Which again, going back to the fact that you are not a doctor who would diagnose or treat anxiety or depression, but because you go about treating the brain itself mm-hmm. and the diagnostic testing that you do allows you to see exactly what's happening, you are able to help these people get relief from the symptoms of depression mm-hmm. and anxiety. Mm-hmm. Not
Absolutely.
That you're saying you can cure it, but it's mm-hmm. amazing how quickly they see relief. And mm-hmm. I know it's a 3 to 6 month program, but people within a week can see their life, the lights come on, the sun mm-hmm. comes out.
Mm-hmm. And usually within a month, because of what we had spoken many times before about neuroplasticity.
Mm-hmm.
In order to change the brain, we gotta be consistent. And if we can make those connections correctly, and it builds on that, then that stress that gets thrown at you, your brain handles it, absorbs it, deals with it, and moves on.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you go talk to your therapist or you meet with your psychiatrist or your counselor and you talk through those emotions, now your brain's not in that constant fight or flight, so it's able to process the emotions appropriately
yeah.
the way your brain's intended
yeah.
to do it.
If you're interested in this information and you want more, log on to brainrehabclinic.com. Dr. Hatch and I had an in-depth discussion about the science behind how he treats anxiety and depression to learn more and learn about what it is that you do.
This is a way to educate the general population on possibilities that they might look into.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't necessarily have to be here with me. It could be any practitioner around the world or looking for other avenues that might help them or something they haven't tried because
mm-hmm.
they never knew that this involvement of the brain was important to their care.
From a patient standpoint, I'd recommend that you get this webinar and take a peek at it because you're gonna save time and money in the long run, because when you actually do get to sit down with Dr. Hatch and go over your diagnostics, he can focus more on the personal, the very specific to your condition, your brain, what's happening, and answer all of those questions rather than doing the overview with you. So if you're interested in this webinar, just click on the education tab at brainrehabclinic.com or give them a call and set an appointment for a consultation, because you can always just get in here and get on the books and you can know that you are going to be on your way to wellness and feeling better. That is for sure. Thanks so much for having me. I'm so excited that we have this chance to chat again.
Thanks for coming.
I'm gonna go get gyro stimmed, I think.
Okay.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back on Talk 365 TV right after this.